this morning. For each and every one. Amen. I thank God for all that He's doing, for giving us the health and ability to be here today. Amen. He gave us the health and the ability to run in a race this past Friday evening. Amen. There was a few of us ran. Amen. And oh, what a good time it was. Amen. You see, we're in a race. We're running this thing called life, aren't we? We're in a thing called life. And we see it, it gets hectic sometimes, and it gets busy. Who can agree with that? Amen. But oh, I tell you, we see that we've all finished the race. We all did very well because we finished. Amen. And it's so good to have the health and ability and be surrounded by brothers and sisters in Christ. 70, 75 years old, that we're riding the race with us. Amen. And I thank God for the way that He blessed and the way that He moved. And just, oh my, what a wonderful evening it was. Amen. It was after dark when you got to the fifth hour. Amen. Because, oh my, you want to come back and hear the word that God has for you this evening. I'm struggling between two different messages today. Rarely ever do that. Well, I do it quite often because there's always messages. Amen. The devil has got one he wants you to preach, and God's got one he wants you to preach, and then you got one you want to preach. Amen. And the saints of God praying make all the difference. Amen. Knowing, amen, that the saints of God are interceding through the week on what the man of God needs to preach. Amen. And oh, what a wonderful joy it was to be running and walking and jogging with people this past week. I think there's 159 people ran in this race. Amen. I don't know how many of them was Christians, but got a lot of comments on the shirts. Amen.
Amen.
I like that shirt you got on. Amen. They may not have been able to read what it said. Amen. They may not have been able to tell, but you know, jogging with Jesus, the ones that was behind me, they know it. Amen. The ones that saw me coming in front, they know it. They see the cross, they know. Amen, because I didn't have to say a word to them. Amen, but it was a testimony. Amen, we were running the race and we were running it together. And that's what we're doing, amen. It's not who finishes first or who finishes last. It's just that you finish. And the Word of God says so. Over in the book of Matthew, turn with me if you would over to Matthew chapter 19. Matthew chapter 19. Amen. You got your place, please stand in reverence for reading of God's word. We're going to be in chapter 19, then we're going to jump over down to verse chapter 20. Got your place, amen.
Amen.
But many that are first shall be last, and the last shall be first. For the kingdom of heaven is like unto a man that is a householder, which went out early in the morning to hire laborers unto his vineyard. And when he had agreed with the laborers for a penny a day, he sent them into his vineyard. And he went out about the third hour and saw others standing idle in the marketplace, and said unto them, go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right I will give you. And they went their way. Again he went out about the sixth and the ninth hour, and did likewise. And about the 11th hour he went out and found others standing idle, and saith unto them, why stand ye here all the day idle? They say unto him, because no man hath hired us. He saith unto them, go ye also into the vineyard, and whatsoever is right, that shall ye receive. So when even was come, the Lord of the vineyard saith unto his steward, call the laborers and give them their hire, beginning from the last unto the first. And when they came, they were hired about the 11th hour. They received every man a penny. But when the first came, they supposed that they should have received more. And they likewise received every man a penny. And when they had received it, they murmured against the goodman of the house, saying, these last have wrought but 1 hour, and thou hast made them equal unto us, which have borne the burden and the heat of the day. But he answered one of them and said, friend, I do thee no wrong. Didst not thou agree with me for a penny? Take that thine is and go thy way. I will give unto you this last even as unto thee. Is it not lawful for me to do what I will with mine own? Is thine eye evil because I am good? So the last shall be first, and the first last. For many be called, but few are chosen. Let's pray again. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you today, Lord, for the reading of your word. We thank you, Father, for each and every soul that's here. We pray, Lord, that you'll move into this message, that you'll speak to every heart and every life. And Lord, we just pray that you'd work in a mighty way. God, that you'll just speak and touch. And Lord, we know, Father, what everyone here is here for a word from you. And God, we want to obey the Holy Ghost. We don't obey ourselves. And Lord, we just pray, Father, that you'll draw the lost, reclaim the backslidden, and God, that you'll give us each the word that you would have us to have today. And we're going to give you all the glory. In Jesus' wonderful and holy name, I pray, amen. Before you sit down, there's one beside you and say, it doesn't matter where you finish, just as long as you finish. Amen. Because you can't just up and run 3.1 miles or walk 3.1 miles and do it like that. Amen. You have to train. You as a Christian, you may have been saved for many, many years. Amen. But you're in training. Yes. We'll be in training until the day the Lord calls us home. Amen. We'll be in training until we draw our last breath. Because we are to study to show ourselves approved unto God, a workman that needeth not be ashamed. Dividing the word of truth. We have to rightly divide the word of truth. We're in training. We had to train, and during that time of training, we had to sign up.
Yes. Amen.
We had to fill out a form and sign up where if we dropped over dead of a heart attack, they weren't liable for it.
Yes.
Amen. We had to sign up, and that's like you. You have to sign up to be a Christian. Amen. You have to give your heart to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Just knowing the race is going on isn't good enough. Just knowing you got to be in it. You got to be in it to win it, amen. You got to be in it to finish it. And in this race, we had to pay a price. But Jesus has already paid the price for you to become a Christian. He's already paid the price. He paid it in full with his blood because you are not your own. You've been bought with a price. You've been bought with the blood of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You've been redeemed. Redeemed means purchased. You're not your own. Oh, Christian, you need to be training every day. Your prayer life needs to be existent. Without a prayer life, I'd venture to say you are lost.
Amen.
Amen. Because if you're not talking to the one that died for you, if you're not talking to God Almighty, if you're not talking in the Spirit, if you're not talking to Him, how good of a relationship could you possibly have?
Amen.
Amen. And it's all about a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. It's not the preacher's relationship. It's yours.
Amen.
Your relationship with Him. You either have one or you don't.
Amen.
Amen. Well, I kindly do. No, you're not kindly saved or kindly lost. You're either saved or you're lost.
Amen.
There is no middle ground.
Amen.
Amen. You need to make sure that you say you're saved, because salvation is not so bad.
Amen.
Amen. We were running this race, and there was a big old thing, blow-up thing. We all had a number. Amen. Mine and Tammy's was 114. Hers was 115. Amber 116. Amen. We all had a number. Just like everyone in here has got a name. And you know your name is either written in the Lamb's Book of Life or it is not. Amen. Your name is either written down or it is not.
Amen.
And when He opened the books in the book of Revelation, amen, when He opened the book, your name had better be in the book.
Amen.
Your name had better be written down. Because if your name not written down, amen, you're not in the race. Hell will be your destination.
Amen.
Hell, not heaven. Oh, preacher, I come to get encouraged. I hope you do leave encouraged today. I hope you leave saved today. I hope you leave stronger in the Lord today.
Come on.
Because through all this training, sitting here, listening to a long-winded preacher, yeah, talk about the Word of God and the grace of God and the blessings of Jesus Christ, amen, oh, it'll make you stronger.
Amen.
You may not remember everything I said. You may not, but you don't remember everything you had for breakfast this year either. But it kept you going. You come in and you get a little bit of the Word, it keeps you going, though. It keeps you going and it keeps you strong and it keeps you moving forward. And that's all we got to do. We got to keep moving forward in the Lord. We got to press on toward the mark and try the high calling of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. We got to press forward. Oh, this race wasn't easy. There was young people. There's young people, man. Some of them little boys are too gone. And little girls, too gone. Beat this old man. Before the race started, there's this man that I know him. But Amber looked at me. She said, "Daddy, right there's your competition." Said, "He runs all, I already knew he runs all these races." And me and him started right beside each other. Always have. I mean, this is the first one I've run a long time. We always have started beside each other. And I always read it. Man, he's fast. He beat me every time. Man, that horn went off. And oh, I started getting it. He's right here. He'd already looked at me once. Amber said, "Did you see that?" I said, "Yeah, I saw that." I didn't let it discourage me. If anything, it motivated me a little bit. But you know, we took off, and about a mile into that thing, I heard him huffing and puffing like I was, sound like two trains coming up through there. I heard him humming and humming, and I started praying. I'm like, "Lord, I need that second wind." And any of y'all ever run or did any type of exercise, you know there's a second wind you get. And amen. God breathed that breath into me, and boy, I took off. I got that second wind, and I passed him. And I passed him, and I was like, "Woo!" You know, thank you, Lord. And I kept on getting it. I kept on getting it. I told Sunday school class this is all about me, but you can relate this to you.
Amen.
Amen. I kept on getting it. And I kept on getting it. And I kept on getting it. And then we got to the turnaround point. I turned around. And man, he was a minute behind me. I don't look back. Amen.
Amen.
Word of God tells us not to look back. Up. You don't, any man who hasn't put his hand to the plow looking back is not fit for the kingdom of God. Amen. That's not talking about running in a 5K race. That's talking about looking back where you came from. Because look back where you came from.
Amen.
You're like a dog turning his own bond.
Amen.
Well, watch out, wallowing in the mire. We see how we don't look back. Amen. While we're in the race. But it's good to look back sometime and remember where God brought you from.
Amen.
But see, I was headed to the finish line. Just like you are today, Christian. You should be headed toward the finish line. You got people pushing you beside you and behind you. Amen. We should be pushing one another.
Amen.
We should encourage one another to do better, to go farther and faster, to hold each other accountable.
Amen.
You see, that gentleman whose name, he had his name on the back of his shirt. That's the only reason I know his name. We have spoke over the years at many races, but I know it hurt him when I passed him. Just like it made me feel good. Fine. But I kept getting it. And man, about 2 miles, they had markers at the mile, 2 miles. And when I got back to that marker, I was like, whoo, man, I'm about to die. I knew I'd already ran the fastest mile I ever ran. I wasn't going to tell you how fast that was. Amen. But I didn't go as fast on the second mile. But I picked up a little steam on the third mile. And then I finished pretty good. But you see, amen, finishing is the key.
Yes.
On the way back, I passed everyone else that was in the race.
Amen.
I didn't get to speak to everybody. You know that. I could barely breathe. I couldn't speak to anybody. That's all I got. Right there. Everybody give me one of these. All right. That's all I got. Because I had to keep breathing. Amen. But I saw all kinds of people. Amen. And I just getting. And I kept getting it. I was like, I know where I'm at. I know I don't have a whole lot farther to go. When I get to this point, I'm really going to start kicking. Man, I got to that point, and I found out I was already kicking it. I didn't have any extra oomph in me. I only done got up and oomph. Amen. But I had this gentleman in front of me that I figured was about my age in my age group. And I'd never seen him before. And he passed me back about 2 mile mark. He going by me like, oh. And man, I was trying to catch up to him. I just couldn't do it. But you know, he finished in front of me. I finished behind him. I'm still in sight. But you know, we both finished.
Amen.
You see, we both finished. And you see, finishing the race is the most important part.
Amen.
It's not where you finish, just that you finish.
Amen.
Amen. And training is very important as to where you finish. Without training, if you never read the Word of God, you're not going to know what you need to know.
Amen.
You, if you are saved, you're going to want to get into the Word.
Amen.
You're going to want to get in the race, stay in the race, and finish well.
Right.
What did the Apostle Paul say? I have finished my course. He fought a good fight. He finished his course. He knew his life was about over with.
Amen.
Amen. He knew he had fought a good fight. He knew he had faced a lot of opposition in his life. And as a Christian today, you're going to face a lot of opposition.
Yes.
As a Christian today, people are going to hate you.
Right.
The world, not Christians, we're to love one another.
Amen.
But the world will hate you. Jesus even told us that. Jesus said, you'll be hated among all men for my name's sake.
Yes.
For his name's sake. We'll be hated. But you know what? He loves us.
Amen.
People may tell you they hate you, but God loves you.
Amen.
Look to one side and say, God loves you.
God loves you.
The Apostle Paul faced a lot of opposition in his life, but through that opposition gave opportunity.
Amen.
Through that opposition, it's opportunity to be a witness to people.
Amen.
Through that opposition, you can accomplish great things. Because you know your adversary, the devil, is a roaring lion. While he walks about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. Amen. He's walking around looking for us, looking for Christians. He wants to devour you. You may feel like you're being devoured today. Some situation in your life might feel like it, you just can't go any farther. But you can go farther because the Lord is your strength.
Amen.
If you're saved. And greater is he that's in me than he that's in the world.
Amen.
Amen. When you need that breath of fresh air, that second wind, he'll breathe it into you.
Amen.
But you have to patiently wait upon the Lord.
Amen.
Lord, give me that second wind. It may not happen right then.
Right.
You may have to go through a lot of stuff.
Yes.
Before that second wind comes, and then you can make it the rest of the way.
Right.
Amen. Because that second wind is crucial. Amen. You need it sometimes. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
Anybody in here ever about give up?
Amen.
You know, when we're most likely to give up on things when we're almost finished. Right now is not the time to give up. Now is not the time to throw in the towel. Now is the time to buckle down. Amen. Now is the time to trust in that anchor. And we do have an anchor. In the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We have an anchor that will hold us and secure us in the strongest of storms of your life.
Yes.
We have an anchor, amen, that will keep us where he needs us. Because he says he will, he'll keep us. He'll keep us.
Amen.
I'm glad that he keeps us. I'm glad that he loves me. Because I sure can't do anything on my own. God sure gave me a whole lot more than I deserve. If I got what I deserved, I'd be in hell.
Amen.
Amen. It's only by the grace of God that I'm saved. It's only by the grace of God that I'm alive. It's only by the grace of God that I'm standing here with friends today. Only by the grace of God. What did Apostle Paul say? I am what I am. Why? By the grace of God.
Amen.
We are what we are by the grace of God. What are you today? Are you in the race? Are you a competitor? Amen. Now I tell you, there's a lot of spectators there too. There's a lot of people watching the race. Amen. I had one dear sister. She was there. Her knees bothered her. She didn't walk in. But later I got on Facebook and I saw she had videotaped me coming across the finish line. Said our pastor finished 8th overall.
Amen.
And man, the way I looked coming across that line. Sister Sharon, shame on you. No. I'm glad you've done that. But I tell you, I was like, what in the world? I look like I'm finally able to make. Which I was. I knew I was right then. I knew it. So I was giving it all the little bit that I had left. I didn't know she was recording until after the fact. But everybody always told me I looked weird when I run. Man, I know it now. I know it now, sister. Thanks. But at least I'm running.
Amen.
I'm not talking about the race. I'm talking about I'm running this race called a Christian. I'm in this race of life. I'm in this race, amen, to make it to heaven, which you and I all should be in.
Amen.
You should be in the race. You should be saved.
Amen.
If you're here and you're not saved, you need to be.
Amen.
Well, preacher, how do I get saved? Well, you come to the knowledge first, knowing that you need a Savior.
Amen.
Amen. Knowing that you need a Savior. And that Savior, he is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
God sent his Son to die on the cross for you.
Yeah.
Amen. You come to that realization. The Spirit of the Lord's already working with you because the Holy Ghost is drawing you.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Because no man can come unto the Father but by him. No man. The Spirit of the Lord has to draw you.
Yes.
When he draws you, it's time to get saved.
Yes.
Amen. Then you believe and then confess, Lord, I'm a sinner. Say, I'm a firm believer. Before you step out of that pew, the Lord already knows your heart.
Yes.
You're saved before you ever get up here.
Amen.
Amen. Because he knows what you're going to do. He knows what you're going to follow through with.
Amen.
It takes follow through too.
Amen.
Amen. When you're running this race, you got to have follow through.
Yeah.
Amen. I crossed that little finish line. I saw my time. I didn't just stop and get a bottle of water. Amen. I had to keep walking or I'd have fell over. I had to keep going. I followed through. And I said hello. Then I had time to speak to the people that had beat me. How you doing? Man, you run good. Hello, hello. Amen. And you got to have follow through. In follow through, regardless of when you get in the race, you see the parable that Jesus is using here. Verse 20 should have actually went into the first part of chapter 20, because Jesus is talking about the same thing. Amen. But many that are first shall be last, and the last shall be first. And what did he finish with in verse 16 of chapter 20? So the last shall be first, and the first shall be last. For many are called, but few are chosen. Amen. He calls everyone to salvation. Many are called. It's not God's will that any should perish, but that all should come under repentance. Amen. He wants all men to come under repentance. All women, boys, girls, children to come under repentance. He don't want anyone to perish and go to hell. Many are called, but few accepted. Few are chosen. Amen. You see, we have people that came in at different points during the day in the parable which we read. We had people that came in and they worked all day long, man. In the heat of the sun, you heard them complaining, didn't you? In the heat of the sun, they worked all day long. Man, and they started work that morning. Then you've got people that come in, amen, they come in at 12 o'clock, at 9 o'clock, at 3 o'clock, amen. And then they even had some that came in at the 11th hour of the day. Man, it's getting late in the day. And then the goodman of the house, the vineyard, the man on the vineyard, he asked his servant to go get him and pay him. But start with the last first. And they all got a penny. Could you imagine being back here at the back of the line, have worked all day in the hot sun, dirtier than stink, sweaty, smelly? He comes to you and you're like, boy, I want to rack up. You get the same penny that the man that come in and only worked the last hour of the day got. Wouldn't that make you mad? It made some of them mad. They murmured. But you see how God works. No matter if you get in when you're 8 years old or 88 or 98,
amen,
amen, you're in.
Amen.
Praise God. You may not have got in when the first time he called you, but praise the Lord, you got in. Praise the Lord. Getting in is what matters. Get in and stay in. Have follow through. Don't give up. When life gets hard, don't give up. Keep pushing on. Because it's about over with. A man is born and born in a few days and full of trouble. Amen. It goes by fast. You see, he made the same wage. Amen. But you notice in our text that nobody was called at the 12th, at the end. Once you die, you're dead. You're dead. You already made your decision while you were breathing. The 12th hour represents the end. Nobody was called at the 12th. They didn't get anything. Oh, my. We see, amen, you don't want to wait to the end of life to get saved. You don't know how fast it's going to happen, because death can happen that fast. The Lord can come back how fast? In a moment, in a twinkling of an eye. Amen. He can come back that fast. Are you ready to go? Are you in the race? Are you training? Have you got follow through? Amen. You've got to be in it. Amen. You see, it doesn't matter what time you get in, because none of us are worthy.
Amen.
None of us are worthy. Our righteousness are as filthy rags in the eyes of the Lord. None of us are worthy.
Amen.
If you're worthy of salvation, raise your hand. None of us are worthy. But God loved us.
Come on, brother.
For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. Thank God. He loves us. We're worthy in his eyes through the blood of Jesus, because shall not remember them anymore.
Amen.
I thank God for the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
What can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Thank you.
That's the only thing that can.
Praise
God. Oh, what can make me whole then? Nothing but the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
We need Jesus. He doesn't need us. We need Him. Amen. Oh, thank God.
Hallelujah.
We see, amen, that the time is coming when the race is going to be over. Amen. The race is going to be over. We're going to be in heaven. There's going to be people in hell. Where are you going to spend eternity? You're going to be in the winner's circle, you're going to be in hell. You're going to be wearing a medal, enter in thou good and faithful servant. Thou's been ruler over a few things, I'll make you ruler over many. Or will he be saying, depart from me, you worker of iniquity, I know you not, or I never knew you. Oh my, that is so sad. But I want him to say to me, enter in thou good and faithful servant. That should be the words you want to hear. And through Jesus, that's the words you will hear. Amen. Because the word of God tells us that as it is appointed unto a man wants to die, after this is judgment. Judgment day is coming.
Amen.
Who in here is going to die? Every hand in here should have went up. I guarantee, unless the Lord comes back, every one of us in here are going to die. Well, I thought you was going to encourage us. Well, I am. I just verify the truth. 100% of us are going to die unless the Lord comes back. Then most of us will be called out here. 1 Thessalonians 16. Amen. We see, for the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord.
Amen.
We'll ever be with the Lord. When that trumpet sounds, we're out of here, Christian. Praise God!
Amen.
It could be today!
Amen.
Are you ready? Where would you spend eternity? You already know!
Amen.
It doesn't matter if you got in at 80 or 88 or 98 or 8. When that trumpet sounds, when you breathe your last breath, you've already made your decision.
Amen.
It's an eternal decision.
Amen.
It's heaven or hell. You already know where. I hope I'd go to heaven. Well, it's not a hope-so thing. It's a know-so thing. You know it. You know if you're saved and you know if you're lost.
Amen.
Oh, we're running this race. And it's about over with. Who agrees with that?
Amen.
We look around and we see the things that's going on in the world. We know it's about over with. We see prophecy being fulfilled. But we also know the Word of God tells us when you see these things come to pass, look up for your redemption will draw nigh. Amen. But also, these things gotta happen. Amen. We don't know when the Lord's coming back. We just know that He's coming back. We know He's coming back in a time and an hour which you think is not. So you got to be ready all the time.
Amen.
Amen. You got to be ready today.
Amen.
Today, if you hear His voice. Today.
Amen.
Today could be the last day. Because we're all saved by grace. Amen. It's not by works. It's not by anything you've done. It's by the grace of God.
Amen.
For by grace are you saved through faith. That not of yourself is a gift of God. Not of works, lest any man should boast. It's nothing you have done. It's what He did.
Amen.
He sent His Son to die on the cross for you. Amen. Thank God.
Praise the Lord.
Whew. We see, amen, how getting in this race, you've got to get in it to win it. Musicians, if you'll come. I don't know your heart today, but I know that God does. God knows your heart. The Lord may have convicted you today. Amen. But you know, if He did, you need to be saved. You know, it's not a little medal you're going to get. I'm not the only one got one of these. There's a whole bunch of people got this. I finished 8th overall. I just thank God I finished.
Amen.
That's just like this Christian walk.
Amen.
Amen. We just have to finish. We just have to finish. Amen. Are you even in it? Have you signed up? The price is already paid.
Woo!
Thank God. The price is already paid. It's not a t-shirt you're going to end up with.
Amen.
Amen. It's not a medal. Oh, isn't it? It's better than a medal. It's better than a medal. It's eternal life.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, hallelujah. Make me want to shout.
Amen.
Eternal life you'll end up with.
Praise the Lord.
But if you don't know Christ, you'll end up with eternal damnation.
Amen.
Oh, that's sad. You don't have to today. If the Spirit of God is drawing you today, today you need to be saved. Let's all stand. If you are saying, I need this man not called Jesus, I need to repent of my sins, I need to get saved, I want to spend eternity in heaven, now's the time to come to this altar. I can't save you, but I'll love to pray with you. There's other Christians here that love to pray with you. We'll help you in your training. We'll help you. We'll guide you along. We'll answer your questions. If you need to be saved, now is the time.